You may have heard that the Observable Framework is a static site generator. But what does that mean, and why would that be a good thing? In short, it makes the experience for the users of your dashboards and data apps much better by making them load much faster. It also reduces load on shared resources like databases by querying data only once that might be used by many different people. In addition, it gives you more control over when the data is refreshed, which can be quite critical and is often overlooked. Let's look at how a dashboard loads in your browser when you use a traditional BI tool. To get the dashboard, the browser has to first request a page from the server. The server, in turn, has to figure out what goes onto that page. There are at least two parts to this, the structure of your dashboard and the actual data. The structure can live in a database or a file, so the web server has to load that information now. If you're familiar with content management systems like WordPress, they work the same way and have some of the same performance issues. Once it knows the structure, it can now query the big database for the actual data to be shown. This can also take a while because production databases aren't usually optimized for the sorts of queries needed for dashboards. It then has to run any data processing on it to create the result set that the browser needs to render the dashboard. Finally, the entire thing gets packaged up and returned to the browser, which can now render the dashboard for the user. But the user kicked off this whole process and had to wait for it to complete. A static site generator, like Observable Framework, works very differently. A build process runs independently of the user. It accesses the code and data, which might be coming from files or databases. It can run lengthy queries, complex data transformations, and so on that may take a long time to complete. The results of this process then get packaged up into a small package that contains the code and result data. This is the static part of a static site generator, because Framework generates a file, or a small handful of files, that contain the product of all these processes in the same shape as what would be sent to the user's browser. It's also usually quite a bit smaller because it can be aggregated to the appropriate level of detail and optimized for space efficiency. Now when the user requests the dashboard or data app, all the server has to do is access that package and send it back to the user's browser, which then uses it to render it onto the screen. This is much faster because all the slow operations have already happened without the user having to wait for them. Now, just because this is a static site doesn't mean it can't still access databases from the browser directly. In fact, because Observable Framework uses code, you have all the flexibility to do whatever you want here. This even includes querying data the dashboard was sent to from the server in the package to drill down, change filters, and so on. But the key advantage is that even if many people request the same dashboard, that doesn't generate more load on shared resources like databases. They all get served the same static package, and it don't get slowed down by other people querying the same data from a database. Now you might wonder how this works if you want your data to be up to date. The key here is that for most use cases, changes to your data during the day or even during a week or month aren't material and can be more of a distraction than actually help make decisions. We have a blog post about this, which I'll link to below. But a common problem is the appearance of a trend when there's just incomplete data. Like in this case, where you might have an incomplete day or week at the end. Once we're past this point and the data is complete, it might look quite different. The answer to this is scheduled builds that run at certain intervals. These can be short. For example, you might run your build every hour. But more likely, you're going to run them once a day, week, month, or even quarter. This is certainly not the case for all data, but for the vast majority of business use cases, a properly managed process of scheduled updates will lead to more useful dashboards and fewer distractions caused by noise or incomplete data. What about row-level security, I hear you ask? That is, of course, possible as well. Rather than just one package, the build process can create separate packages for each user or role. That way, when the request comes in, the server can then decide which package to serve them. This might seem to go against my earlier point about not having to run so many queries, but the build can be much more efficient with its queries than having to do it fully on demand for each user. The result is also still much faster for the user, and maybe your user permissions are by department or role, in which case multiple people still get served the exact same package. A static site generator does not mean that the data is static, or even stale, or that the dashboards can't be interactive. Quite the opposite. Because you can do so much more processing and observable dashboards are built with code, you can enable many more ways to interact, explore, and model than with traditional BI tools. Observable Framework especially when served by Observable Cloud, makes for much faster dashboards, lower server load on your shared databases, and more useful dashboards with scheduled data updates.